भगवती वासुदेवाय ओं नमो भगवती वासुदेवाय ओं नमो श्रीमद्भागवतम नाइन्थ कैंटो चैप्टर 9 टेक्स्ट 33 एवं करुणवासिन्या वीळपन्त्यावनाथवो व्याघ्रपशुमिवा खाद सौदासो सापमोहितो ट्रांसलेशन बाय श्री प्रभुपाद बीइंग कंडेम्ड बाय द कर्स ऑफ वशिष्ठ किंग सौदासो डिवोर द ब्राह्मण एग्जैक्टली एज ए टाइगर इट्स इट्स प्रे इवन दो ब्राह्मण्स वाइफ स्पोक सो पिटेबली सौदासो वाज अनमूव्ड बाय हर लैमेंटेशन पर्पट बाय श्री प्रभुपाद दिस इज एन एग्जाम्पल ऑफ डेस्टिनी King Saudaso was condemned by the curse of Vasishtha, and therefore, even though he was well qualified, he couldn't restrain himself from becoming a tiger-like rakshasa, for this was his destiny. Tallabhyati dukhavadanyata sukham Srimad-Bhagavatam 1.5.18 As one is put into distress by destiny, destiny can also put one in a happy situation. Destiny is extremely strong, but one can change destiny if one comes to the platform Krishna consciousness. Karmani nidahanti kintu cha bhakti bhajam. Brahma Sangita 5.54. This verse says, evam karun karuna bhasinya vilapantya anathavat vyagra pasumiva khadat saudasa sapamohita. Being condemned by the curse of Vasishtha, King Saudasa devoured the Brahmana exactly as a tiger eats its prey. Even though the Brahmana's wife spoke so pitiably, Saudasa was unmoved by her lamentation. In purport, Srila Prabhupada says this is an example of destiny. King Saudasa was condemned by the curse of Vasishtha. Therefore, even though he was well qualified, he couldn't restrain himself becoming a tiger-like rakshasa. For this was his destiny. Tallabhyate dukhavat anyata sugham. Srimad Bhagavatam 1.5.18 As one is put into distress by destiny, destiny can also put one in a happy situation. Destiny is extremely strong, but one can change destiny if one comes to the platform of Krishna consciousness. Karmani nidahanti kintu cha bhakti bhajam. Brahma Sangita 5.54 So this is called, this is example of destiny. Destiny is karma phala, that is result of your past karma, prarabdha karma, that is destiny. It is written. There is one saying, kapalo likhano ke korivano. What is written in your destiny, nobody can alter it. It's strong, it says. Destiny is extremely strong. Nobody can alter it. You have to have it. You have to reap its consequence. This is here. Saudasa was cursed by Guru Vasishtha. Saudasa was a very qualified king. Many good qualities he had. But he did such things as Guru Vasishtha cursed him. Therefore he turned into a rakshasa, tiger-like rakshasa. So, the Brahman Patni, the wife of the Brahmana, even though Brahmana's wife spoke so pitiably, so that's unmoved by them. Because he couldn't restrain himself, because that is karma phala, his destiny. He couldn't restrain himself from becoming a tiger-like rakshasa. This was his destiny, karma phala. Karmani nidahanti kintu cha bhakti bhajam. Unless one comes to the path of bhakti, unless one comes to the platform of pure Krishna consciousness, one cannot change the destiny. Only Krishna can destroy it. Otherwise, nobody can destroy karma phala. It is very strong. Brahma Sangita, it is said, Jastu Indra Gopam अथवा इंद्रं अहं स्वकर्म बंधान रूप फल भाजन मातनोति कर्मा निदहंति किंतु च भक्ति भाजं गोविंदं आदि पुरुषं तम भजामि। वन हैज बिकम इंद्रगोप, इंद्रगोप ए टाइनी वर्म, रेडिश, लुक रेडिश, जनरली दे आर फाउंड इन रेनी सीजन इन सैंडी प्लेसेस, we say Indragopa, you understand? They are found here, I don't know whether it is found in western country or not, I don't know it, but they are found here. Yes, in rainy season we find, we say Indragopa. Reddish, worm, how, why? One has become Indragopa, another jiva has become Indra, heavenly king, king of the heaven, the planets, king of the demigods. One jiva has become Indragopa, tiny reddish worm, another jiva has become Indra, heavenly king, because of karma phala, because of their destiny, you understand? Their past karma. One who does very pious activities, he may be elevated to the heavenly planet, he may become Indra. He may become Indra. And one does very abominable activities, sinful activities, so he may turn into Indra, he'll get that birth, Indragopa, that tiny insect, reddish insect. Because karma phala, this is destiny. But karmani nidahanti kintu ca bhakti bhajan govindam adi purusham tamam bhajami. But adi purusha govinda only can destroy karma phala, the result. Karmic reaction, nobody else can do it. Therefore, Prabhupada Maharaj says, destiny is extremely strong. Destiny is extremely strong. But one can change destiny. How to be changed? If one comes to the platform, pure Krishna consciousness, karmani nidahanti kintu ca bhakti bhajan, he comes to the path of bhakti, comes to the platform, pure bhakti, Krishna consciousness, sarva-dharmān parityajya māmekam saraṇam vraja antaṃ sarva pāpebhyo mukhyeṣi māsucha. This is the most concluding instruction, most confidential instruction of Krishna in Bhagavad Gita. One who, abandoning all varieties of dharma, completely surrenders unto the lotus feet of Krishna, then Krishna destroys all his sinful reaction, karmic reactions. Otherwise, nobody can destroy. Nobody can destroy. Only Krishna can destroy, unless one comes to the pure platform, pure Krishna consciousness, karma phala cannot be destroyed. Destiny cannot be changed or destroyed. Has to. Do you follow? Many instances are there. You'll find there are 84 lakhs of species, isn't it? 84 lakhs. What are they? Bolo. Yes. 84 lakhs of species are there. Yes. Jalaja navalakhyani. Jalaja navalakhyani sthavara vinsalakhyati krumeru rudrasankhyokar pakhinang dasalakhyakam trinsalakhyani pasavo chatulakhyani manava. Total 84 lakhs. Aquatic animals are 9 lakhs of types. 9 lakhs of types are aquatic animals. Sthavara vinsalakhyati, trees, mountains, they are sthavara. They are of 20 lakhs of types. Krumera rudra sankhyokar, krumi kita potanga, worm, jar, insects, they are of 11 lakhs of types. Pakhinanga salakhyakam, 10 lakhs of types of birds are there. Trinsalakhyani pashago, the animals, beasts, they are of 30 lakhs of types. And chodulakhyani manava, 4 lakhs types of human beings are there. Total 84 lakhs. Do you understand? It's total 84 lakhs. So how it is determined and how one gets this birth? According to one's karma phala. Do you understand? According to one's past, result of past activity, that is known destiny. Do you understand? One has become insect, one has become tiger, one has become bird, one has become aquatic animal, one has become tree, mountain. Huh? This Nara, Kubera, Manigriva, they became trees. Huh? Isn't it? They were two sons of Kubera, two Gandharvas, in heavenly planets, higher planetary system. They did such karma, such activity, they took the birth of trees. Do you understand? Narada Muni cursed them. Do you understand? This activity is karma. The phala. This karma phala. The Indra, heavenly king Indra, once that is there, he disrespected the Devaguru Brihaspati. Disrespected Devaguru Brihaspati. Understand my language? The guru of the demigods, Brihaspati. Once Indra disrespected. Therefore, Brihaspati cursed, become a hog. So, he became a hog. Yes, this is karma phala, this is the result of his activity. He did such karma. He disrespected his guru, therefore became a hog. Completely forgot that once he was Indra, heavenly king. He completely forgot. Yes. Have you remembered what was your previous birth? Completely forgotten. Nobody has remembered. So, staying in the mounds of stool, eating stool, one hog wife producing hundreds of children, all are eating stool. Hundreds years passed. Brahma took pity on him. Are he? This fellow was Indra. What is doing now? Eating stool? Completely forgotten. Can't remember. So Brahma came down and asked, "Hey, what are you doing? Don't you know? You are Indra, heavenly king. What are you doing now, eating stool? Can't you remember?" Brahma said 2, 3, 4 times, didn't listen. No, didn't listen to him. Brahma thought of, my words will never enter into his ears. My words will never enter into ears. Why? Because he is so much attached, so strong attachment he has for this material enjoyment. Vishayasakti. Do you understand? He has very strong attachment towards this material enjoyment. So my words will never enter into his ears. Unless this attachment is finished, he won't lend his ear to my words. Brahmana. Because Brahma Mahajana. Brahma is Mahajana. One of the 12 Mahajanas, first Mahajana, Brahma. Brahma knows. So, Brahma first killed his hundreds of children, killed them. And children are killed, became angry, roared, raising his tusk, ran towards Brahma. But what can he do? Brahma is very powerful. Brahma then said, "Hey, don't you remember? You are once Indra, now what are you doing?" Still he didn't hear. Still Brahma's words didn't enter into him. Brahma again thought, his attachment is not completely finished because his wife is there. Again produce children. Some attachment there. So then Brahma killed his wife. The children were killed, wife was killed. My children were killed, wife was killed, nobody was there. Then became angry, ran towards Brahma, till Brahma said, "Hey, what are you doing? Don't you remember you are Indra? You are now eating stool?" Then he listened, because all attachment is finished now. Then he listened, "What are you saying? Indra, heavenly planet. Oh yes, you are in heavenly planet, you are king of heavenly planet. Surga Raja, Indra. Do you want me to go there? Asked Brahma. Do you want me to go there? Yes, you are there. Is stool is available there? If sea hog is available there, then I will go. Such attachment. It is so strong, you see. Are Baba, if there is Amrit, is there Amrit? Nectar. What is a stool? The nectar is there. A sea hog. Angelic, very beautiful angelic girls are there. Apsaras are there. Denizens of heaven there. Very, very beautiful Urvasi, Menaka, Ramba. Your wife, Indra's wife, Sachi, very beautiful woman, lady is there. What sea hog, guys? Still such attachment, such attachment. You understand? That is what. Mahajanakam, Sadhukam, speaks Krishna Katha. How many are hearing really? Whose ears this Krishna Katha is really entering? Is entering into your ears? Astananda. One who has very strong attachment to this material enjoyment, his katha will never enter into his ears. No. Maybe sitting is only pretending that he is hearing, pretending, but really is not hearing. As long as this material attachment is there, very strong attachment, Krishna katha, Bhagavata katha, Sadhur katha will never enter into his ears. When the attachment will completely finish, then he will hear. Do you understand? Yes. How many have come to get Krishna? Bolo. How many have come to get Krishna? You take statistics, you'll find very disappointing statistics. Disappointing, very, very disappointing. Have you come to get Krishna? No. Many have come. Yes. Nice, nice enjoyment. Nice enjoyment will available. Yes. We'll join in the society of Krishna consciousness. A nice prasad is available, car will be available, fly in the air, travel in West, many, many far off countries, we go there. Do you understand? We'll become Vaishnava, sadhu, many people come, pay dandavat and give pranami. Some donation will be available. Isn't it? Very hard struggle. Jivan Sangram, very hard struggle for existence. Material world, very hard struggle for existence. Yes. It's done, very nice, done in the society of Krishna consciousness. Very easy, very easy. Very nice arrangements are there. Nice and arrangements of enjoyment is there. Yes, you will earn so much dollars, yes, so much dollars. Do you follow? How many have come getting Krishna? They have this desire for enjoyment. Do you follow? Mahaprabhu came. Mahaprabhu is Krishna. But Mahaprabhu came as a devotee, bhakta bhavangikari, assuming the mood of a bhakta, devotee. Mahaprabhu came to teach us devotion, how to surrender unto Krishna, how to render loving service unto Krishna, how to get Krishna. So how many understand Mahaprabhu? How many think that Mahaprabhu is so wonderfully merciful, wonderfully munificent, wonderfully magnanimous, that he descended here to teach us how to surrender Krishna, how to serve Krishna, how to render loving service unto Krishna, how to cry for Krishna, to get Krishna and make your life successful, perfect in this very life. But as long as you have this material enjoyment, Mahaprabhu's words will never enter, Vaishnava words, Sadhu's words will never enter into your ears. Most of them think that Mahaprabhu will give us all sorts of enjoyment. Mahaprabhu is like a gardener, Mali. Yes, माली हया करे ब्रह्मांड भ्रमित कौन बोलो माली हया करे से बीजे रोपण श्रवण कीर्तन दले करो सेचन नित्य सिद्ध कृष्ण प्रेम साध्य कबु नय श्रवण आदि शुद्ध चिते करो उदय सो wandering, 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 lakhs, lakhs of brahmandas, lakhs, lakhs of spaces. Once someone is fortunate by the mercy of Guru and Krishna, gets the bija, seed of bhakti creeper. Isn't it? Then bhakti creeper, the seed is sown, then there is watering, shravan kirtan. Then gardener, gardener's business to sow the seed and water. Watering is there, Shravan Kirtan, hearing, chanting is the watering. The gardener does so. Mahaprabhu came as a bhakta, do you understand? Like a gardener, do you understand? He sows the seed and he allows everybody to come and hear the Shravan Kirtan. Nitya Siddha Krishna Prema Sadhya Kabunoy, Shravana Adi Siddha Chite Kuru Yudhaya. Krishna Prema is not so easily available. Is not sadhya so easily, but sravanadi suddha chita, you come to sadhu and hear Krishna katha, concentrated attention, surrendering unto sadhu, giving up all your desires, thus surrendering unto sadhu, get sadhu's mercy, then Krishna katha will enter into your ear, by his mercy you will develop Krishna prema. Do you follow? So this is question, question is here, the gardener, the Mahaprabhu acted like a gardener, Mali. He sowed that seed, then that creeper develops. Regular watering is there, Shravan Kirtan, then creeper develops. Grows, grows, develops, then goes where? Upujya Bharelata Brahmanda Bhedi Jai, Viraja Brahmaloka Bhedi Parabhyama Jai. तबे जाऊ तदुपरी गोलक वृंदावन कृष्ण शरण कल्प वृक्ष करे आरोहण ग्रोज एंड ग्रोज 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 एंड गोज अबव दिस ब्रह्मांड मेटेरियल यूनिवर्स देन क्रॉसेस विरजा क्रॉसेस ब्रह्मलोक विरजा देन एंटर्स इनटू परब्रह्म स्पिरिचुअल स्काई देन ग्रोज. But you should continue watering Shravan Kirtan. It is eternal, do you understand? Continue. Then at last it goes to Golok Vrindavan, topmost planet, Golok Vrindavan. Krishna Sarana Kalpa Bukhya Karyarana. Creeper, Lata wants support. What is support? Support is Krishna Sarana, the lotus feet of Krishna. That is support at last. The creeper, bhakti creeper, go and support. Guess that support, Krishna Sarana, the lotus feet of Krishna, that's like Kalpa Vrukhya. That's like a desire fulfilling tree. Do you follow me? Taha vistarita haya phale prema phala, yaha mali seche nitya sravanadi jala. There, but mali, the gardener, is engaged daily watering. Watering is Shravan Kirtan, do you understand? Engage. Still, one should always engage, daily engage. Every day you should be engaged in Shravan Kirtan, that is watering. So, then creeper will produce their fruit, flower and fruit. Fruit is prema. Krishna prema is fruit, prema phala. Still, you should not cease this watering. The watering, Shravan Kirtan should be continued. When this prema phala is there, then now ripened fruit is there. The gardener gets the fruit. Gardener is Mahaprabhu. Do you understand? Mahaprabhu is gardener. The gardener gets fruit. Prema phala. So he gets gardener now. Mahaprabhu is gardener, he gets prema phala. So, when that fruit is there, he becomes very, very happy. Now, so many fruits are there. What to do? I am one gardener. How can I eat everything? The Mahaprabhu is not selfish. Do you understand? Selfish. He distributes. Do you follow? He distributes to everybody. He distributes to everybody. Mahaprabhu Mahapadanya is the most munificent incarnation who freely, indiscriminately gives Krishna prema. Indiscriminately gives Krishna prema. Here is mentioned in Chaitanya Charitamrita, you'll find
अतएवे आमी आज्ञा दिलु सबाकारे अतएवे आमी आज्ञा दिलु सबाकारे जहाँ तहाँ प्रेम फल देहो जारे तारे जहाँ तहाँ प्रेम फल देहो जारे तारे एक लामाला करो आमी कत फल खाबो एक ला करो आमी कत फल खाबो ना दियाबा एत फल आमी की करीबो ना दियाबा एत फल आमी की करीबो अतएव सब फल देह जारे तारे अतएव सब फल देह जारे तारे खाइया हो कलो को अजर अमोरे खाइया हो कलो को अजरी अमोरे.
इन महाप्रभु लीला महाप्रभु हैज गिवन इंडिपेंडेंस टू कृपा शक्ति. Understand? Mahaprabhu has given independence to Krupa Shakti, mercy potency, Krupa Shakti. But in other incarnation, Krupa Shakti is under Ichha Shakti, not independent. Is under Ichha Shakti, will power, will, supreme will. Supreme Lord has supreme will. He is supreme, supreme personality of Godhead. Krishna, his will is supreme. You understand? So Krupa Shakti is under Ichha Shakti. Understand my language? Is under Ichha Shakti, under supreme will. But in Mahaprabhu's incarnation, Mahaprabhu gave independence to Krupa Shakti. Krupa Shakti is not under Ichha Shakti. Understand me? Therefore says, Mahaprabhu gave this independence. Now you distribute this prema phala whomever you like. So much, so many fruits are now. Ekala malakar, I am only one gardener. How many can I eat? I am only one. So you distribute. Mahaprabhu gave independence to Krupa. You distribute whomever you like. Otev sapphala deho jare tare khaya hauka loko ojore amare. Let everybody get. Let you eat prema phala. You become deathless, ojor, omor. No old age, no death. Ever fresh young man. Mahaprabhu is so merciful. Mahaprabhu has given independence. So, one may think, this Jagadish Pandit may think, oh, Mahaprabhu is so merciful. So, Mahaprabhu will make all arrangements for my enjoyment now. Yes, Mahaprabhu will make all arrangements of my enjoyment. If you cherish this desire, this is bhoga buddhi. This is the desire for material enjoyment. So the Harikatha will never enter into your ears. No. Though you may come, sit here. You are just pretending that you are hearing. Really, Harikatha is not entering into your ear. Because you have bhoga buddhi, you have desire for enjoyment. And Mahaprabhu is like gardener. He'll make a very nice flower garland, or what do you say? Bunch of flower, full of toda. Okay, flower, just take it. If you develop this desire, then bhagyahina, unfortunate, ill luck. That is ill fate, ill destiny, bad destiny will come to you. Though you may come and sit here, but you cannot hear Krishna katha, Bhagavad katha, will never enter into your ear. If good fortune comes, Brahmanda Ramiteko Bhagyavana Jiva, fortunate Jiva, wandering in lakhs of Brahmanda, lakhs of spaces, comes in contact with sadhu, and surrenders into sadhu, surrenders into the lotus feet of sadhu, then begs for his mercy, concentrated attention, crying for the mercy of sadhu. Hears, and he is completely, his all desires, material desire for material enjoyment, desire for material liberation, completely destroyed. If fortunately, then he will hear Krishna katha. Krishna katha will enter into ears. Otherwise, cannot enter. Do you understand? That happened. Brahma knows this thing. Therefore, Brahma thought, why so much material and attachment he has. Unless the attachment is finished, this fellow will never listen to me. You follow? So this is karma phala. This is karma phala. This is the result, destiny. This is the result. This is destiny, karma phala. It will never be destroyed. Karmani nidhanti, unless one comes to the path of pure Krishna consciousness, pure bhakti, completely surrender by the mercy of Sadguru, Guru Krishna Kupate Pai. This karma phala will never be destroyed. Only Krishna can destroy. Destiny will be changed, Rupa says. Destiny will be changed if one comes to the platform of pure Krishna consciousness. Otherwise cannot be changed. So one becomes, he was Indra, now is hog. Similarly, Bharata Maharaj, emperor of the world, very pious king, gave up everything, came to the Kulahapulasthi ashrama, engaged in sadhana bhajan. He made so much advancement, yes. Do you understand? He was very, very elevated. Still, yes, in subtle corner, attachment was there. So he became attached to a doe, Murgasavaka, to a doe. And he forgot everything. He forgot meditating Krishna, always meditating doe. Such attachment. So at last, when death, time of death, he thought of the doe. Left the body, then next birth is body. He got the body of a deer, isn't it? Couldn't go back, come back to Godhead, because he couldn't think of the Lord at the time of death. This is attachment. He did such activity. This is karma phala. This is karma phala. This is destiny. This is the karmic reaction, result of his activity. Such an elevated personality. Such an elevated personality, Bharata Maharaj. In Mahabharata, there is one is there. It's Nahusha. Is Nahusha the famous king? The famous king of Soma dynasty, Soma Vansha. Is the son of Ayu, King Ayu. He's a very pious king. He has performed many pious activities. He's a very powerful king. He's so powerful, even demigods were inviting him to heavenly planet when there was attack. Demons, you understand? Demons were attacking the demigods there. So demigods are inviting Nahusha to give them protection. Yes, such king. So he had done so much pious activities. As a result of his pious activities, he was elevated to heavenly planet and became Indra. He became Indra. Then Nahusha became Indra. He was king here, then he became Indra. When he became Indra, he became very puffed up, proud. So he engaged the Brahmanas in carrying his palanquin as King Rahugana engaged Jada Bharat, a great Brahmana. Similarly, the Nahusha engaged the Brahmanas carrying his palanquin. Once he engaged Agastya Muni to carry his palanquin. Agastya Muni, famous Brahmana. And by chance, his leg touched the body of Agastya Muni. Agastya Muni got angry and cursed, "Hey, rascal, what are you doing? You are so puffed up, becoming Indra and doing this." So he cursed him, "Sarpa Bhava, become a serpent." So he became a serpent, snake. He was king of heaven, Indra, now serpent. So this is karma phala, destiny. The phala, this is destiny, karma phala. Karmani, jagnyarthat karmana, natra lokayam karma bandhana. Gita says, if your karma activity are not done, if your karma is not done for the satisfaction of jagya purush, Bhagavan Vishnu or Krishna, there must be karma phala, bandage of karma, reaction of karma, isn't it? That's karma phala, that is destiny. That is destiny. That is there in Mahabharata. Another episode is also there in Mahabharata. One Vedic Pandit was there. He has studied Veda, acquired Vedic knowledge, but he had no bhakti. Only Vedic knowledge he has acquired and scholarship he had. Once he was going on the road, and some of his friends are also there, other Brahmin friends were there with him. They were going. He saw very nice palatable food lying on the road. Very nice. Palau, rasgulla, jilpi, laddu. Very nice, palatable. And Brahmins generally are very greedy. Oh, very nice food. It's just lying on the road. But a ghost worshipper, those who worship ghosts, they prepare nice food and offer to ghosts. A ghost worshipper had offered that food to ghost. So he ate it. That Brahmin ate it and also gave that food to his friends. All right, you eat. All of them ate. So after a few years, they all died. So they were all brought to the abode of Jamaraj. Because Jamaraj will take decision, what birth, well, what will be next birth. You understand? In Jamaraj's court. So in Jamaraj's court, Chitragupta opened their book, Chitragupta keeping book, every individual human being, what is doing, good work, bad work, evil work, yes, everything. But then Chitragupta opened and said, this, they have done this thing. So Jamaraj gave this Nishpatti decision, you will remain in the species of ghost. This is your karma phala. Remain in the species of ghost. Ghost means no gross body, only subtle body. To remain in subtle body, very, very painful, very, very painful. Yes, very, very painful. Therefore, ghosts always want to enter into some gross body. They enter into gross body, they will get some relief. Otherwise, very painful. So Jamaraj said, you'll remain in ghost body, ghost faces. Then that their leader, that Vedavid Brahman said, why will it be like that? Then you have done this thing. You are a Brahman, but you have not performed Brahmin activity, Brahminical activity. You ate the food offered to ghosts. So this is karma phala. You have to do, you have to reap it. Nobody can change it. Have to remain. In the species of ghost. Nobody can change. Then they paid obeisance at the lotus feet of Jamaraj. How can we be delivered from this bondage? Please tell us the means. How will be delivered? Jamaraj said, you definitely remain in the species of ghost and you remain in a deserted place. Deserted place, Maru Anchal. If by chance a Vaishnava goes there, he must be very, very thirsty and hungry. If you serve him, get his blessings, then he may be delivered, otherwise he may not be delivered. That Dharmaraj Jamaraj said. So they remained in ghost places hundreds of years in a deserted place. By chance, a Vaishnava went there. Vaishnavas traveled throughout the world. Throughout the world they traveled, preached the science of Krishna consciousness. Do you understand? Because they are very, very merciful. Their heart bleeds seeing the suffering of the jivas. Their heart bleeds. Because out of ignorance they have been suffering, let me go there, impart this Krishna consciousness, inculcate Krishna consciousness unto them, and they will be delivered. Their suffering will be, mitigated forever. Go back home, back home. They are so merciful. So they go everywhere, throughout the world. So they also go to deserted places sometimes. So by chance, a Vaishnava came to that deserted place where these Brahmins were in ghost places. They couldn't see, Vaishnava, his Tilak is there, Shikha, shaving head, chanting Hare Krishna by attire, garment. One can see Vaishnava chanting Hare Krishna. Immediately they remember what Dharmaraja said. Deserted place means scorching heat of the sun overhead. Underneath, sand is there, very hot, blisters coming out on the feet, sole. Thirsty, no water, no tree, no shady tree. The Vaishnava was thirsty and hungry, scorching heat, blisters coming out and so. So when they saw, yes, Vaishnava has come, Jamaraj has said. So some of them took the form of the trees. Oh, very nice trees here. Vaishnava sat down under the shady shade, a cooling shade of the tree. And that leader of that ghost party, that Brahmin, Vedavid Brahmin, he took the form of a Brahmin, human being, came there and asked, how can we serve you? Vaishnava said, I am very thirsty, hungry. So immediately he went, brought a glass of cold water and some fruit. Yes, ghosts do very nice work. If you can engage them, yes, they will do very nice work. Some sadhakas are there. Yes, I know one sadhaka is still here. Baba, he's a Pakhi Baba. He's Bhuta Sadhaka. Yes. He uses the ghost to do work. Yes. You follow? So, the Vaishnava immediately offered and that fruits to Bhagavan Vishnu, make prasad, so he ate. Then his remnants he gave them. But the ghosts, asariri, they have no gross body, they are subtle body, they cannot eat like this, they only smell, ghost smell. When they smelt, immediately they got very nice demigods body, divya, devatanu, they were delivered from ghost places and they got very nice demigods body, then they came paid obeisances, a lotus feet of Vaishnava. Vaishnava became amazed. Then he asked, what had happened to you? Then he related the whole story. You understand? This story. So this is karma phala, this is destiny. According to one's karma phala, destiny, one may be elevated to the swarga or may go down to narka. If someone is fortunate, gets sadhu krupa, vaishnava krupa, thereby gets krishna krupa, karmanididhan, then his karma phala will be destroyed. He'll get mukti. Otherwise, karma phala cannot be destroyed. No other means is there. Karmani niddhanti kintu cha bhakti bhajam govindam adi purusam tamaham bhajami. This bhakti is very powerful. Bhakti is very powerful. Karma, jnana, yoga. Karma, jnana, yoga is not so powerful. Bhakti is powerful. That's what Chaitanya Charitamrita says. Bhakti vina kon sadhan dite nare phala. Sab phala deva bhakti sodantra prabala. Ajagala stananya anya sadhana ateva hari bhaje buddhiman mana. One is buddhiman, one is intelligent. Sab phala deva bhakti sodantra prabala. Ajagala stananya anya sadhana ateva hari bhaje buddhiman mana. One is buddhiman, one is intelligent. He accepts the bhakti patha. He accepts the path of bhakti, he gives up the path of karma, jnana, yoga. Anya sadhana, karma sadhana, jnana sadhana, yoga sadhana, cannot give you the perfection. They are like anya sadhana, ajagalastananya anya sadhana. This karma sadhana, jnana sadhana, yoga sadhana, that like ajagalastana. What do you say? And Aja means goat. Two, nipples hanging at the neck of the goat, ajagalastana. Looks like order, but no milk will come out. Ajagalastana na anya sadhana, fruitless. Bhakti is very powerful, svatantra prabala, saphala deva bhakti, svatantra prabala. Bhakti is very powerful. Ajagalastana na anya sadhana, ateva hari bhaje buddhiman jana. One is buddhiman, one is really intelligent, wise. He'll adopt this bhakti process, giving up the other process of karma, jnana, yoga. Do you follow me? Because when one comes to the, here Prabhupada says, if one comes to the platform, pure Krishna consciousness, platform of pure Krishna consciousness, then his destiny will be changed. Karmani niddhanti kintu cha bhakti bhajam. Sarvadharman parityajya mamekam saranam braja. Giving up all varieties of dharma, just surrender unto me. Ahantam sarvapapebhyo mukhishyami ma sucha. Krishna says, abandoning all varieties of dharma, just surrender unto me. If someone may think, I'll give up all dharma, then I'll become a dharmika, irreligious. Then I'll commit pap. But Krishna assures you, don't fear. Mahasucha means don't fear. I'll destroy all sinful reactions. Only Krishna can destroy. If you come to the path of pure Krishna consciousness, pure bhakti, Krishna can destroy. Krishna can change the destiny. Otherwise, nobody can change. Karma phala is so strong. Therefore, Prabhupada says, destiny is extremely strong. It cannot be changed. But one can change destiny if one comes to the platform of Krishna consciousness. Do you follow? Yes. It will change. According to our karma, it's all written. It's all written. It's all settled up. It's all written. This sukha, dukha, happiness and distress must come to you. You have done some good work and bad work. Some pious activities, some sinful activities. For pious activities, some happiness will come. Sinful activities, distress will come. It's all written in your destiny. Do you follow? It will come. Nobody can change it. Only if you completely surrender, only Krishna can change. Other destiny cannot be changed. One such story is there, that one person was there, very bad fortune. Bad stars, planets are there. Sunny Mahadasa, Rahu Antara. Bad planet, very bad planet, evil planet is Sunny, Saturn and Rahu. Sunny and Saturn both have come. He went to a suffering. He's going to die. Went to the astrologer. showed his horoscope chart. Please see what is that. Astrologer calculated. Oh yes, very bad. Sunny, Saturn and Rahu, two evil planets have come. You cannot survive, you die. Marak dasa. Death must die. How can I be saved from it? Who can change it? Nobody can change. It's written. Strong destinies cannot be changed. Only Krishna can change it. It's up to Krishna. Nobody else can do it. You follow? So, he became so disappointed. Oh, I'll die. All right, only Krishna can change. If I completely surrender unto Krishna, only Krishna can. Sarvadharman paritya mami kunsa antan sarpape vyam gaisami. Only Krishna can change. Nobody can change. Destiny cannot be changed. So he came. He came to Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami, Prabhupada Maharaj. That story. It's true story. And he surrendered unto Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami. Maharaj, please protect me. This is bad destiny I have. Astrologer says I'll die. Two very powerful evil planets, Shani, Saturn and Rahu are there. I'll die. So he took shelter of Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami, Vaishnava. So Vaishnava Sarma says, all right, only Krishna can change it. Nobody can change it. You surrender unto Krishna Sarvadharmana Paityajyamami Kumsanandu. Completely surrender. Become Krishna Das now. Now become Krishna Das. Engage in Krishna's loving service. So here, he became disciple of Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami and engaged under his guidance, engaged in loving service unto Krishna. He didn't die. He didn't die. Death didn't come to him. He survived. If you see his horoscope, he is dead. But how is he surviving? How it happened? His horoscope chart says he's dead. He's dead. But he survived. You see? This is only Krishna can change. He survived. He became great sadhu mahatma. Yes. Great sadhu mahatma. This is Gaudiya Vaishnava. He is Sramana Maharaj. Sramana Maharaj. Sramana Maharaj. Yes. Sramana Maharaj. Sramana Maharaj. Disciple of Bhakti Siddhanta. Yes. Such many instances. Only Krishna can change. Nobody. The one who is completely surrendered. There is no necessity of going to astrologer, see what happens to me. Why? Because it's all gone, finished. Prarabdha karma is, if you achieve the namana stage, your prarabdha karma is destroyed. No more. Namabhas. If you achieve namana stage, prarabdha karma is destroyed. It's destroyed. I'll go to astrologer. You see my horoscope, my chart. No need. And completely surrender, soul never goes. It's completely dependent on Krishna. Jai Krishna ichha nahi karibo nijo ichha mate kichuna chindibo. Krishna's will is powerful will. He can do and undo things. That is that destiny, that death will come, I'll die. Only Krishna can change it. Nobody can change it. So completely surrender unto Krishna. It's up to Krishna. Rakhe hari mareke mare hari rakheke. If Krishna wants to kill, is there anybody to protect you? Krishna wants to protect anybody to kill you? Do you understand? Rakhe hari mareke mare hari rakheke. If Krishna wants to protect, nobody can kill you. Death will never come to you. Do you follow? Death will never come to you. Jamaraj will never come to you. Jamaraj is the superintendent of death. He comes as death. Murti hum sarva rasa. If you are completely surrendered to Krishna, so he can change your destiny. Death will never come to you. It is mentioned in Shastra. Sakrunapi Krishna padara bindayo nivesitam tad guna ragi jairiha nate jamam pasabhutascha tad bhatan Sopne api pasyanti hi cherna niskrutaha. You have that Bhagavatam? Sixth canto, Bhagavatam, see this verse. Sukadeva Goswami says to Parikshit Maharaj, 6.1.19, Sakran manah krishna padaravindayo nivesitam tadguna ragi jairiya na te jamam pasabhrutascha tadabhatan sapne api pasyanti hi chinna niskruda. You found? Read translation. So, in the dream even the Jamaraj will never come. Do you understand? Supne. Nate jamang pasabhutasadad bhatan. Supne api vasindhi chinna nishkudha. Jamaraj will never come to you. Death will never come to you. Do you understand? It's completely sakran mana krishna padaravindaya nivesidang. Tadguna ragi jairiya. Nate jamang pasabhutasadad bhatan. Supne api vasindhi chinna nishkudha. Where is karma para? Where is your destiny finished? It's all changed. Krishna can do and undo things. Only he can change. Otherwise, destiny is very strong, cannot be changed. You have to repeat. Understand? One buddhiman, one who is intelligent, wise, immediately he surrenders unto the lotus feet of Krishna. Sarvadharman parityajya mamekam saranam raja antansa papebhya mukhisyami masusa. No question of destiny at all. Finished. It's all changed. Krishna can change. Nobody can change. Destiny is strong. Only Krishna can change. So Prabhupada has also quoted this verse. You find out 1.5.18. Tasaiva heto prayate to kovido na labhyate jada brahmatam uparjadha tal labhyate dukha vadanyata sukham kalena sarvatra gavira rangasa. Find out. 1.5.18.
Persons who are actually intelligent and philosophically inclined should endeavor only for that purposeful end, which is not obtainable even by wandering from the topmost planet, Brahmaloka, down to the lowest planet, Pala. As far as happiness derived from sense enjoyment is concerned, it should be obtained automatically in course of time, just as in course of time we obtain misery, even though we do not desire them.
Only intelligent person, only endeavor for that bhakti, which is not attainable in 14 bhuvan, 14 planetary systems, going to topmost planet and nethermost planet. Tasaiva heto prayateta kovida na labhyate bhramato uparjadha ta labhyate dukhavad anyata sukham kalena sarvatra gambhirarangasa. That says. Prabhupada quoted that thing. As one is put into distress by destiny, destiny can also put one into happy situation. Destiny is extremely strong, but one can change destiny if one comes to the platform of pure Krishna consciousness. Karmani nidhanti kintu cha bhakti bhaja. One is intelligent, wise person, he must make endeavor, you know, how to get bhakti. Do you understand? Bhakti dhana. Bhakti is an invaluable asset. Invaluable asset, and it is durlabha, rarely achieved. One cannot get it even going to the topmost planet and nethermost planet, wandering in 14 planetary system. This bhakti dhana is durlabha, is rarely achieved. But one who is really intelligent and wise, he must endeavor to get that dhana, bhakti dhana. Do you understand? And one gets that bhakti dhana, that means come to the path of pure Krishna consciousness, destiny is changed. According to one destiny, one gets distress and happiness. That it will completely change when it comes to the path of your Krishna consciousness. And wise and intelligent, he must endeavor for that. Have to get bhakti dhana. Nipala. Bhakti is very powerful. One comes to pure devotion, path of pure devotion, you have no desire. Na dhanam, na dhanam, na sundarim kavitamba. Jagadisha kamaye mama janmani janmani sri bhavatad bhakti rahit vidai. You have no desire for material enjoyment, no desire for material liberation. Bhukti, mukti, only one desire. Life after life, I will serve your lotus feet, Lord Krishna, and give you all happiness, all enjoyment, all pleasure. I never ask anything for me. Do you understand? That is bhakti. Bhakta. So, bhakta, such a bhakta, such a dear devotee, this swarga, brahmaloka, even, emperorship of the whole world, yoga siddhi, very, very insignificant. He kicks it out. Na naka prushtam na ta paramisthyam, na sarvabhama na rasadhipatyam, na yoga siddhi rapunabhavamba, samandra satta virajya kankhe. This is a completely surrendered soul, a dear devotee. 6.11.25. Find out that verse. Na naka prushtam na ta na yoga siddhir punarbhavam va samanta sutta virajya kankhe. Oh, my Lord, source of all opportunities, I do not desire to enjoy in Dhruva Loka, the heavenly planets, or planet where Lord Brahma resides, nor do I want to be the supreme ruler of the earthly planets or the lower planetary systems. I do not desire to be master of the powers, mystic yoga, nor do I want liberation if I have to give up your lotus feet. Only one desire, to give up your, to get your lotus feet. A pure devotee never desires to gain material opportunities by rendering transcendental loving service to the Lord. A pure devotee desires only to engage in loving service to the Lord, in constant association of the Lord and His eternal associates. As stated in the previous verse, Dasa Daso Bhavita Asmi, as confirmed by Nartam Das Thakur, Tandir Sarana Sevi, Bhakta Sani Bhas, Janame Janame Hoy, Ehi Abhyas, to serve the Lord and the servants of His servants in the association of devotees, only objective of a pure, unalloyed devotee. No other desire is there. You understand? So, for him, all destiny is destroyed, all karma phala is destroyed, nothing. Because it's completely under Krishna, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, who can do and undo things. Such a devotee desires what? Na kama yana atho tadapyahun kochin, na jatra jusma charanam bujasava, mahattamanta hrudayanam khachyuto, Vidat Sukarna Yito Esamibara. 4.20.24. This is Prithu Maharaj's prayer. Na kamayanatha tapyahum kochin, na jatra jasmat saranam budasavaha. Mahattamanta hrudayan mukhachyuto, Vidat Sukarna Yito Esamibara. Only one benediction I want. I mean, millions of years, let me have millions of years and hear your Krishna katha from the lips of your pure devotee. This benediction he wants. I don't want anything. So, no desire at all. Why? Karma phala will work well with their destiny. Destiny is completely changed. Jamaraj will never come in the dream, it is said. That is hinted here. So King Saudasa, he was cursed by his Guru Vasishtha, therefore he was turned into a man-eater rakshasa, like tiger. Tiger. This is destiny. So being condemned by the curse of Vasishtha, King Saudasa devoured Brahmana exactly like the tiger eats his prey. Even though the Brahmana's wife spoke so pitiably, Saudasa was unmoved by her lamentation. Therefore, even though he was well qualified, he couldn't restrain himself from becoming a tiger-like Rakshasa, for this was his destiny. destiny. As one is put into destiny, it cannot be destroyed. But one can change destiny if one comes to the platform pure Krishna consciousness. Karmaani dhanti kintu cha bhakti bhava. Only Krishna can change. Nobody can change. Understand? One who becomes completely surrendered and the lotus feet of Krishna, sarvadharman paritejya mame kunsaram braja, all destiny changed, finished. No more karmic deyasana, no prarabdha karma, finished. Even when you attain namavara stage, your prarabdha karma is destroyed. Yes, you follow. In Mahaprabhu's Leela, you will find this, that this is, what is that? Subhadirai. Subhadirai. Subhadirai drank some water from Mamadan's house. So, Mamadan, cow killer, beef eater, so sinful activity. So, I committed sin. Then what atonement, what sort of atonement I have to perform to free from this sinful reaction? She went to the pandits of Kashi. In Kashi, the pandits are there. He said, this sinful activity I have committed. What atonement? The pandits turned over the pages of their shastra. They said, oh, this if you have to eat very hot ghee, this is the atonement for this sinful activity. Then you will be free from the reaction of the sin. Very hot ghee. He thought of, yeah, if I drink hot ghee, I'll die. I'll die. I won't. So he didn't do it. He didn't do it. He waited when Mahaprabhu came. He went to Mahaprabhu and asked Mahaprabhu, Mahaprabhu, I have done this thing. I went to the pandits of Kashi. They told me this, to drink a very hot ghee. This is the atonement. Mahaprabhu said, no, this is not proper atonement. No, this is not proper atonement. It's karma prayaschita. Therefore, three types of prayaschita are there. So, the materialistic persons, they go to the pandits. They have committed some sinful activities. Bad planet has come. Saturn and Rahu. He'll die. They go to pandits. Oh, Pandit Mahasaya, what shall I do? Bad planet. Evil planet has come. All right, you offer puja to that planet. Sunny puja, Rahu puja. Isn't it? The pandits say, all right, you have to drink very hot ghee. But Mahaprabhu said, no, this is not real atonement. It's karma prayaschita. This is known as karma prayaschita. Three types of prayaschitas are there, atonement. Karma prayaschita, jnana prayaschita, bhakti prayaschita. This is karma prayaschita. You have done one karma. The result is this, karmic reaction. To free from this, another karma you have to do. This atonement, karma prayaschita, but it's not real. What is like? This is like kunjara sauchavat. That means, this is like the bathing of an elephant. Elephant, he has dirty body. So he enters into a river, a lake, bathes clearly. As soon as comes out of the lake and river, again puts dirt on his body. So what is the value of his bathing, kunjara saucha. Karma prayaschita is like that. For such time, it may leave you. The reaction of this papa, do you follow? Sinful reaction may leave you for very short time. But again, you will commit pap again. Like the elephant again puts dirt on his body. That is not real atonement. Then something better prayaschita is jnana prayaschita. Jnana prayaschita. That means, one who does jnana prayaschita, he becomes very much repentant. I will never do any sinful activity again. He becomes repentant, very, very repentant. Never do, I will never do. But, still, that's not. Example is Bansanala. Thereby, the sinful reactions You'll never commit any sinful activity, therefore there will be no sinful reactions. So there will be no sinful reactions. But the seed, the root is not destroyed. Example is that a very dense jungle of bamboo is there. That jungle is cut up with fire. The whole jungle was destroyed, burnt up, turned into ashes. No jungle is there, completely finished. Jnana prasthita is like that. But the root is underneath the earth. It's not destroyed. When again there is rain, pour of rain, then again it will sprout. So in Jnana prasthita, the root is not destroyed. The reactions may be destroyed, but the root is avidya. Avidya is the root, ignorance. Nascence is the root of pap, sinful act. That is not destroyed in Jnana prasthita. So that's not proper prasthita. Again, you will commit. Bhakti prasthita is the only prasthita, Mahaprabhu said. Bhakti prasthita is the only prasthita. That destroys the root of avidya. There will be no sprouting at all. So Mahaprabhu said, you chant Hare Krishna, completely surrender unto holy name. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Ram Ram. You completely surrender unto holy name, you chant holy name. If you attain Namama stage, all your karmic reactions, sinful reactions are destroyed, Prarabdha karma is destroyed. Yes, that is the proper prasthita. Then, when you chant pure name, then you'll get Krishna, prema, you'll get Krishna. You'll go back home, back to Godhead. Go to the lotus feet, approach the lotus feet of Krishna, you'll be with Krishna. That is the proper prasthita, atonement. Completely surrenders to Krishna, surrender to holy name. That is what is interior. That your destiny is completely changed, and Krishna can say no. Otherwise, destiny is very strong, nobody can change it. Thank you. गोपाल जी महाराज की जय समवेत भक्तवृंद की जय।